Alan, thanks for watching Proactive New York. I'm joined by Matthew Hornor. He's the president and the CEO of Maple Gold Mines. Matthew, good to speak with you again.
Thank you. Great to be here.
So Matthew, you've had quite a busy summer, so it's a good time to catch up on what's been happening at your projects. Maybe start with the Eagle Mine, because mid-August, you reported initial assay results from the first drill hole of the second phase of the phase two drill program at Eagle. Take us through what you discovered there.
Yeah, it kind of confirmed what we were expecting to find there. We had some quite high grade over short intersections, but we had, for example, 3 meters of 11.4 grams with 1 meter of 24 grams. What we're doing is vectoring, closing in on the areas that are apt to have a higher ounce count with a higher grade overall, which encourages the further drilling and gives us an idea of where to go to phase two and where to go to phase three. There's only been one hole pulled out of that we publicized about phase two. So there's more holes yet to come from phase two, and then phase three is going to start imminently on the back of all that.
In fact, you said in the release last month that it's the best results so far from your 2022 drilling at Eagle. So were you confident about the results you've seen and how the program is going to progress?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. This is one of the most target-rich environments I've ever operated in on any project anywhere in the world, given that it was a prior high-grade producing asset. I'm not surprised, but it's just nice to see that you're not gonna hit on every hole, of course, but we're finding more fire where the smoke is, and that's leading us to the next exploration programs and giving us a lot more confidence as we move forward.
So you said the phase three drilling program is imminent. What's planned for phase three drilling?
Well, we're moving kind of down along strike, parallel long strike as to where they started originally back in 1974. Back then they had the Eagle open pit and they started the high grade there, and they moved kind of down trend, if you will. And we're kind of roughly speaking, following the same pattern where we're starting closer to surface, phase one, phase two, phase three, going deeper and deeper to get to what may end up being the heart of the source rock and the higher grade sections. That's the kind of high level picture of how we're approaching this.
Okay. So of course the Eagle Mine is 100% owned by Maple Gold. You also have two joint ventures. So let's chat about those, because at Joutel, you mobilized a second drill rig and you're aiming for a 6,000 meter program at Joutel. How's that progressing?
Yeah, so just to be clear, Joutel is the mine complex, or the little town that hosted the high grade project in the past. Joutel Mine Complex has Eagle and Talbell. We have Eagle. Talbell is part of the 50-50 joint venture that we have with Agnico. So there we're starting the 6,000 meter drill program at Talbell. It's a 50-50 ownership with partnership. We've agreed to a $4.8 million budget with our partners. That's going to have pay for the deeper holes that we're drilling at Talbell, actually, and at Douay. At Talbell, since you asked there, we're chasing some of these very, very interesting, deeper, higher grade, what starts to look like an area that could potentially have incredibly high grade in size material. But on the way down, we're going to learn a lot from the various sections that we cut through. For example, above Talbell, there was no follow-up exploration drilling by the team back in between 1974 and 93. Why? Because their cutoffs were 6 grams and their average grades that are mining were 6.5 grams. So everything near surface there is in the 2 to 5 gram area that we've seen so far. And as we cut through, we're gonna learn a hell of a lot more about what else is there that they may have left behind that would be interesting in a $1,700-$1,800 gold environment that wouldn't have been interesting in a $300 or $350 gold environment, which is what they were facing back during the period over which they were operating that project. So we're going from surface deeper through to these higher grade targets that were never had to follow up drilling. And when I say higher grade, it's 15, 12, 10 gram rock under the Tell Bell area. And then further off to the southeast, we're looking at an area that had 80 grams rock material, 15 grams, et cetera. And we're chasing that as well. But again, we're going to learn a lot as we go down through the prior mined out area, even above that, that they never even touched. And then, of course, below when we get to the target area. So there's many horizons that we're going to go through and have incredibly valuable information that we achieve as a result.
So your other joint venture, and that's the Douay Gold Project, you also planned deeper drilling this summer to expand ounces and also discover new resources. How did that go?
Yeah, well, that's underway right now. The that area is being drilled as we speak. You know, the Douay section is going to have you know, five or six holes of nearly 2,000 meters each. And the thesis there is we've taken the you know, when you put together, you probably know this, when you put together a exploration program, you have to create what we call these conceptual pits, where we see what the previous drilling has shown as far as grade. You're able to put together a 3D model to say what would a pit look like when we actually go mine the project. In this case, we've worked with our partners who have found massive extensions of high grade, for example, to East Goldie at Malartic. And we've taken some learnings from them, added some of our learnings from ourselves at Douay, and we've essentially virtually inverted the high grade ends of the conceptual pits, if you will. So imagine there's a conceptual pit design. We've kind of virtually flipped it upside down and then vectored off the high grade at the base of those conceptual pits. And that's how we've created the drill program to go deeper into what we believe is going to be the very high value target at the source rock. So that's what we're doing there. We're excited to learn all about what's going on below that. It's amazing that this kind of work program has never happened over the course of the history of this project over 40 years. It's something that nobody else would do without an Agnico partner with you along for the ride. And we're extremely excited about what we expect to find down there. Not all the holes will be success, of course, and that's okay. This is riskier exploration work, but I'll be shocked if not at least one or two or three of the five or six return something that's highly important for the project and all of our stakeholders.
So, Matthew, what sort of news flow should investors be looking out from the three projects in the months ahead as the year draws to a close?
Well, we have 30,000 meters to be drilled this year. Only 5,000 meters of assays have been released. So there's going to be 25,000 meters-ish yet to be released to the market. That's all going to be backloaded, if you will, to the end of the year. This is kind of a result of the assays being held up at the labs to a certain degree, but then we had an issue with cutting the core, which we've resolved now. So all that backlog is coming through and going to the assays at the labs. So there's going to be a tremendous amount of just drill data that's going to come out to the market over the next few months and last quarter of the of 2022, and look to see, you know, how that shapes the following drill program for 2023, January, February, and beyond in the wintertime as we kick off the 2023 program. So there's a lot of information that we're going to be bringing through the market that I think is going to be appealing to all of our stakeholders.
I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress, but thank you very much for the update today, Matthew.
Sure.
Matthew Hornor is the president and the CEO of Maple Gold Mines.